So guys, in the previous semester you have learned about the distance relay, that is the impedance relay, reactance relay and the mode relay, and you have also seen the operating characteristics of those relays, torque equation and their RX diagram. Now in this lecture you will see it's the implementation of distance relay. So where we can use distance relay and what is mean by distance protection, that we will see in this session. So we already know that the fault current depends upon the system configuration and the generating capacity. So in this case, distance relay are preferred over overcurrent relays. It is also found that overcurrent relays are slower and not sensitive in case of distance protection. So in order to remove the inaccuracy, we are going to use the distance protection. Now consider this scheme. This is a length. There are two lines, that is line AB and line CD. These four cross A, B, C, D, the location at point A, B, C, D, they are the location of the relays. Now the entire location, entire line length, this entire system is divided into three zones of protection. Now for relay A, say for relay A, relay A covers 80% of the length of line AB. Now you will see the cursor, point out with my cursor that at for relay A, the zone 1 is from point this to 80% of the length of line AB. Fine. Similarly, the zone 2 of relay A is covering the remaining 20% of the portion of line AB, and it will covers the extra 20% or 50% of the adjoining line. We will see the case. See over here. Now what will be the case? Now I have already told that relay A will cover the 80% of the length of line AB. So this is the zone 1 of relay 1. Now in case of relay 2, now if there are multiple lines joining this bus, this is the bus, or we can say the generating station or substations. We can say the substation. So if there are multiple lines coming out from this substation, so zone 2 of relay A will cover the 50% of the shortest line. It will cover the 50% of the short, say for example, if this is the shortest line, so relay zone 2 of relay A will cover the 50% of the shortest line. So fine. So this is 2A will cover the remaining 50% or 20% of, in this case 20%, but in practical we will use to cover 50% of the shortest line adjoining from this bus. Now the zone 3 of relay A will cover the remaining section of the line CD. That means in case of zone 3, it will cover from point A to the entire line, that is from A to D. So now we will see over here what is the zones of protection in case of relay B. Now relay V will operate in this direction, that is the relay at point B and C are directional relays. We will see later on why these relays are directional. So zone 1 of relay B is, again it will covers 80% in this direction. See in this diagram, the zone 1 of relay B, this shaded portion is the 80% of length of line. Now we can say it's from B to where, that is from right to left, it will cover the 80% line. So this is the zone 1 of relay B, and what is the zone 1 of relay? That is from left to right, the 80% of line length AB is the zone 1 of relay A. So we will see that the 60%, that is the 80% of line length from left to right, or from there, this to this, see my cursor, this is the zone 1 of relay 1, and from right to left, from B to 80% up to A, this is the zone 1 of relay B. So this 60% line is the overlapping between zone 1 of relay A and zone 1 of relay B. So this 60%, whenever fault occurs in this section, it is needed to be eradicated instantaneously. That means there is no time delay will be provided if the fault exists between this 60% of the line. That means the, also we can see that the main protection as well as the backup protection in this case are instantaneous in nature. And now if the fault occurs in this 20% of fault, in this 20% region of relay B, that means it will comes under the zone 1 of relay B and comes under the zone 2 of relay A. So relay B needed to be operated instantaneously, and there is some time delay of 0.1 to 0.2 seconds will be taken by the relay to operate at position A. Now, similarly, if the fall takes place in this 20% region close to relay A, so it will come under the zone 1 of relay A and zone 2 of relay B. So relay A needed to be trip instantaneously, while some time delay is needed to be provided at relay at point B. Again, the limit of time A and B will be 0.1 to 0.2 seconds. Now, we have seen previously that in this case, that in this diagram, that B will operate in this direction, A will operate in this direction, C will operate in this direction. So the relay at position B and C, the relay in these two positions are directional in nature. And I also tell you the reason why they are directional in nature, So say for example, if there is a fault occurs at this point, that is close to relay B. If the fault occurs over here, see the cursor position, if the fault occurs over here, that is, this is the zone first of relay B. Now, if both the relay B and C are non-directional, then this fault will comes under the zone 1 of relay B as well as the zone 1 of relay C if they are non-directional. So both the relay will fight and compete that which relay will operate. Either relay B will operate and or relay C will operate. So in order to avoid this confusion, we will place directional relay at point B and at point C, so that relay B, say for example, will operate in this particular direction and relay C will operate in this particular direction. The direction will depend upon, it is decided by comparing the voltage and the current. If current lags behind the voltage at some point of time, so we can say B will operate, and if current leads voltage in another direction, so we can say relay at C will operate. So that is the reason why we kept the relays at position B and C to be directional relay. Another point we have, the point that we have to taken into care is why we take only 80% for zone 1. So in this diagram it is clear. Now again I am coming back to this diagram, that for relays of relay at A, the zone 1 is 80% of length of line AB. Now the zone 2 of relay A is the remaining 20% of AB, and the 50% or 20%, in this case we consider, in this case we will consider 20%, but it will be the 50% of the shortest line connected from this bus, and the remaining section will be the zone 3 of for relay A. Similarly for relay B, this is zone 1 for relay B, this is 80% of line BA, and remaining 20% and 50% of the adjoining line from A to another join line connected in this zone. That is the zone B, zone 2 of relay B, and carry on the zone 3 for relay B. Similarly, this is the zone 1 of relay C. This is 80% of CD line will be covered by the first zone of relay at position C. The remaining 20% and the 50% of the adjoining line after point D will be covered by the second zone of relay C. At relay D again, it will cover 80% of line DC, another 20% and the 20% of line BA, and the remaining entire line will be covered under the third zone of relay D. So this is how this three zone protection works in either direction. Now considering the case why we take only 80% of the length of line AB, this is the case why we have taken 80% of zone 1, not 100%. So the answer lies that during a fault, a CT may undergo partial or complete saturation. Now the resulting error in the measurement of the apparent impedance seen by the relay makes it different to determine the fault at the boundaries of the line very accurately. We will see what this is going to tell. We know that the inputs from the relay are given by the CTs and the PTs. So considering the error of these error due to the saturation of these CTs and the PTs, the maximum error will be up to 20%. This 20% plus minus 20% will be considered as the error. Now if, say for example, if fault occurs in this, again follow my cursor, in this region, that is 80% in of length of line AB, that is in zone 1 of AB, so I need this part to be operate, relay A and B will operate so as to remove this fault. Now if 20% of the CT error will added to it, this fault will be shifted by 20% of this up it in this direction, that is from left to right. Again, by considering or adding the 20%, the fault still lies in the region in the region between these buses N and M, M and N. So again, we have the requirement is the operation of relay A and B, and after adding the 20% of the error, the fault is shifted in the same region, so it is adjustable. But now consider the fault occurs at this point. Now follow this cursor. If fault occurs at this point, and if 20% of the CT error is added, the fault will shifted in this zone. So actually the fault is occurred in this zone, but my relay will see relay. The fault is now shifted to the second zone of relay 1, zone 2 of relay 1, and zone 1 of relay C. Okay, so the relay C will operate in this case, but actually the fault is in this this position. Fine, are you getting my point? So what happened, if the fault is in this location, my relay A and B needed to be operate, not relay C will operate. But if I add 20%, the relay A will see the fault occurring over here, and C will operate, which is the malfunction of the relay. So that is the reason why we take 80% of length of line AB, not 100%. Now there is also one more reason of keeping this length to be 80%, that is while deriving the torque equation or the mathematical equation that we have seen in the previous semester, we are not compensating the effect of capacitance. We are not adding the effect of capacitance or transposition of the line, so which in practical will affect. That's why we will keep it only up to the 80% of the line. Another reason for keeping it 80% is, now see one more example over here. Now consider multiple feeder connected with this bus. Now if there is a fault occurs at point F, see this location, this cursor, if there is a fault in this position, so fault current from this source P will travel this path and then reaches to point N, but so the voltage drop from point P to point N will be only the current due to the single source. And if there is a fault over here, current from this source also coming and rushing towards this fault, and now after point N there are two currents, that is current from source P and current from this source, another source, say Q. Now these two currents will follow this path and then feed it into the fault. So voltage drop from at this point is comparatively more than voltage point up to this point. So the entire voltage drop between the point P to point F will be increased. So in this case, if V is increased, Z is also increased. It is clear that the Z is also increased. So the relay will see this fault now, not over here, it will see the fault over here. That means the relay A will now see the fault in the third zone, but it was actually in the second zone. So this type of error is known as infeed error. This is the error of infeed error. That means it now it will comes in the third zone, but it will actually comes under the second zone. Now again consider the case of outfeed. Now again assume this is not the generator, now this is the load. So now the current from this, and there is a fault at point F. Now current from this source will travel this path. Now a portion of current will now goes in this direction to up to the load, and only the remaining portion will feed it into the fault. So now voltage drop at this point will be lesser than in the previous case. So the entire impedance from point P to point F is now reduced. So as impedance will reduce, this fault is now seen by the relay in this region. It is what A, as impedance is related to the length of the line. So A will consider that the fault is not here, but the fault is actually here. So A and B will operate. But in actual case, the fault is occurred over here and my relays at C and D needed to be operate. But what happened? Relay at A and B will operate. So again, there is a malfunction. So in order to avoid this, we will cap the first zone only up to the 80%. Also, we kept the second zone up to be the 50% of the adjoining line. what is the reason behind that? Now see the answer. Now this is the first zone of relay 1, that is 80%. This is relay A. So this is a first zone of relay is up to the 80% of the length of line AB. So this is the 80% of the length of line AB. The remaining 20% of AB, this to this, and say for example now I have exceeded it more than to 50%. So up to 70% I have considered it for the second zone, and now the third zone. Similarly, the relay at C, this is the first zone, that 80% of the length of line CD is 50, the 80% is this up to this portion. So this is the first zone of this, and the remaining 50% will be the second zone of relay at C. Now this region, which is the overlap region of second zone of relay A, this is the second zone of relay A, and this is again the second zone of relay B. So if fault occurs in this location, relays at point C and A again confused or competed to fight that which relay will operate, and again there is a malfunction. So what we done is reduce this region. This distance will be reduced by keeping it 50%, so there should not be overlapping, and that is the reason why we will keep the line 50% to be the 50% of the adjoining line. And in this way the distance relay protection will work, and this is the entire case of distance relay protection. And you will see the various time of operation, that is in second zone the time of operation is the, or we can say 0.2 to 0.5%, and in third zone the time delay is 0.4 to 1 second. Okay, thank you.